All right, time for round two. This hand is okay, although not great. I'm playing against blue-green scapeshift, or normal scapeshift, whatever. Behold the power of replays. Gifts helps a little bit. Didn't play the tarn there because I think I might have to spell snare. And don't want to have to crack it for an untapped duel. Not that I really need to get a duel with it, but might as well. Definitely want to thin my deck out here. I mean, thinning with fetch lines isn't like a huge influence, but if you want to draw land, you might as well not crack your fetch line much of the time. Definitely snaring that. I mean, your spell snares are good in this matchup, but in this case, you know, I think it's better just to use them now. It would have been a good draw last turn. See, if I had Thirst in my hand, I might have not snared some of his stuff because it'd be good protection. Probably going to get Cryptic here. Oh, he's peering. Alright. That means the worst that it can happen is I get remanded. Getting remanded is not a big deal. Oh, or not. Yeah, Mox can go. I like Thirsting before Gifting because if you hit a combo piece off Thirst, you know, you can Gift for the other pieces. Here I'm going to wait a turn off Gift so I can have Muddle up. Now I think, let's see. I'm at 19, yeah. Gifting now is fine. Make him use his remand. Or not. See, he can scape shift me this turn, but only for 18. So, get the combo. And I do have Muddle to transmute for it. I think, Gifts, Thirst, Cryptic, and Thopter Foundry. Ought to give me a start on it. I didn't really want to get Sword Foundry and some useless cards. Here, I'm going to get at least one good card. And he does have a remand in his hand still. Which is important to note. Play Thopter Foundry, but or I think I'd rather have Thirst with Muddle backup, especially since me being at 18 off the Wood Elves isn't a big deal. He's gonna probably be able to scape shift with 8 lands in play if he goes for it. This isn't looking too badly. I'm doing stuff and I've got a couple counters in my hand. Not going to fight over remand, of course, here. I can get rid of explosives. Still don't really want to play Thopter Foundry, I don't think. I think Path is most likely to be more useful than Day. Calling Oracle's fine. I'd rather not show him black lands if I can, just because he might suspect I have cranials in my sideboard. Here I can discard. I don't really want to discard artifact land. I discard Wrath and Path. I don't think that his Coiling Oracle and whatnot are going to beat me down, really. None of these cards really do anything for me. I'm about to run out of Marsh Flats targets, actually. And if he goes off, I can muddle it, spell snares remand, then mana leak whatever he plays to protect it. At this point, I need to save my spell snares for his remand. Key West. That's interesting. Don't really want to attack the Trinket Mage here. Alright, looks like we're going for it here. Escape Shift, Muddle It, Remand, Mana Leak. I think I should be able to stop this here. And we'll find out. Because I can mana leak Cryptic. And Rand doesn't really do anything here because I can just, you know, replay my Muddle. Okay, Cryptic is definitely not happening. Now his best option is to remand the Scape Shift, which I will definitely snare. And hope his last card, I guess, isn't another Scape Shift. Or I draw Cryptic. No. So, let's see. I think I'm actually, depending on how many mountains he's playing, could be one life short of stabilizing here. Catamaran does not do anything. Definitely play Mox for zero. I could Ghost Quarter his Valakut, but I don't need to do that now. Alright, still not attacking with Trinket. Now I do need to find something before he kills me. It looks like he's going to do. Well, he did have every single card in his hand was a counter or escape shift, which is kind of annoying. But game one's not that favorable anyway. I think I might be an artifact or two short of not dying to his remaining Valakut. But I guess we'll find out. Valakut? Yeah, he's putting me to zero, exactly zero here, which means if I had cracked one less fetch land, didn't seem like it was going to matter a little earlier. But I didn't even have time to play this last Ancient Den either. Yeah, I can sack Thopter Foundry, Mox, and Seat, but I go to zero. Alright, it's targeting me with all of them, I imagine. Yep. Alright.